Hello students, in this video we will see some extra exercise for the chapter 2 of class 8 NCERT subject science. The chapter name is Microorganisms, Friend and Foe. In the previous video we had seen the NCERT textbook solution. So now let me start with the exercise. Question 1 is choose the correct option. So in this first question, which of the following is a causative agent of influenza? Options are bacteria, protozoa, fungi and virus. So your answer is virus. Option D. Virus is a causative agent of influenza. Next question. Which of the following disease is caused by a virus? See, options are polio, cholera, tuberculosis or typhoid. So your answer is polio. Option A. Polio is a disease caused by a virus. The next is dysentery is caused by which of the following? The options algae, protozoa, fungi and virus. So your answer is B. Protozoa. Dysentery is caused by protozoa. Next question. Which microorganism causes typhoid? The options are bacteria, protozoa, fungi and virus. So your answer is A. Option A. Bacteria. Bacteria causes typhoid. The next question. Which of the following is a bacterial disease? Cholera, malaria, influenza or dengue? So your answer is option A. Cholera. Cholera is a bacterial disease. The next question. Which of the following microorganisms have chlorophyll? The options are bacteria, fungi, algae or virus. So algae is the microorganism which has chlorophyll. The next is, what is called a fungi seen on moist or stale bread? Options are mold, yeast, mushroom or none of these. So answer is option A. Mold. A fungi seen on the moist or stale bread is known as mold. The next question, which of the following is algae? Options are amoeba, mushroom, paramecium or chlamydomonas. So your answer is option D. Chlamydomonas is a algae. The next question, which of the following is not an antibiotic? The options are streptomycin, penicillin, tetracycline or aspirin. So your answer is option D. Aspirin. It is not an antibiotic. Next question. Who invented the vaccine of smallpox? The options are Louis Pasteur, Alexander Fleming, Dr. Edward Jenner or Robert Koch. So Dr. Edward Jenner invented the vaccine of smallpox. So your answer is option C. Next, 11 number. Which of the following is responsible for the spread of tuberculosis? The options are air, water, food and housefly. So air is responsible for the spread of tuberculosis. So answer is air. The next 12 number. By whom is the disease cholera spread? The options are air, water, mosquito or none of these. So by water cholera is spread. So your answer is water. The next question. Which disease is almost eradicated from the world? The options are malaria, tuberculosis, smallpox and cholera. So your answer is option C. Smallpox. The next 14 number. Which vaccine given to children orally in the form of liquid drops? The options are diphtheria, typhoid, DPT and polio. So polio vaccine is given to children orally in the form of liquid drops. So your answer is option D. Polio. The next question. Which of the following was invented by Dr. Alexander Fleming? The options are penicillin, smallpox vaccine, rabies vaccine or fermentation. So penicillin is your answer. It was invented by Dr. Alexander Fleming. The next question, against which disease does BCG vaccine give protection? The options are tuberculosis, cholera, malaria and smallpox. So your answer is option A, tuberculosis. Against tuberculosis, BCG vaccine gives protection. The next question, which of the following is not a protozoan? So your options are amoeba, paramecium, plasmodium and penicillium. So your answer is option D, penicillium is not a protozoan. The next is, which is called as a connecting link between living and non-living? So options are virus, fungi, algae and bacteria. So your answer is option A, virus. Virus is a connecting link between living and non-living. So here the answer for this, choose the correct option, is also given to you. So now let we see the next exercise, that is fill in the blanks. First blank is, chickenpox is a disease by blank. So it is a disease by virus, caused by the virus. The next is, tuberculosis disease is caused by blank. So tuberculosis disease is caused by bacteria. The next is, malaria is caused by blank. So it is caused by protozoan. So your answer is protozoan. The next is, Dr. Edward Jenner discovered the vaccine for blank. So Dr. Edward Jenner discovered the vaccine for chickenpox. Next is, a technique to make microbes free milk was discovered by blank. So a technique to make microbes free milk was discovered by Louis Pasteur. The next blank, the bacterium blank promotes the formation of curd. So the bacterium lactobacillus promotes the formation of curd. So your answer is lactobacillus. The next is, during alcoholic fermentation process, blank gas is produced. So during alcoholic fermentation process, carbon dioxide gas is produced. The next is, blank is used for commercial production of alcohol and wine. So your answer is yeast. Yeast is produced or used for the commercial production of alcohol and wine. Nine number, female blank mosquito acts as a carrier of dengue virus. So female Aedes mosquito act as a carrier of dengue virus. Next number, when pathogenic microbes enter our body, the body produces blank to fight the invader. So at that time, body produces antibody to fight the invader. So antibody is the answer. Here the answer for the filling the blanks is given to you. The next question, true false. First one, measles disease is caused by virus. So your answer is true. It is caused by virus. Next is, aspergillus is a protozoan. So your answer is false. Aspergillus is a fungi. It's not a protozoa. So your answer is false. Next is, microorganisms like amoeba may live in colonies. So your answer is false. Microorganisms like amoeba can live alone. It doesn't live in colonies. Next, remains of animals and feces are broken down into harmless and usable substance by bacteria. So your answer is true. It is broken down into simpler form by bacteria. Next is, yeast is a multicellular fungus. So your answer is false. Yeast is an unicellular fungi. It is not a multicellular. Next, six number, yeast and mold are one type of algae. So your answer is false. Yeast and mold are one type of fungi. It's not a algae. The next number, 7 number, Lactobacillus are disease causing bacteria. So answer is false. Lactobacillus are useful bacteria. It is not disease causing bacteria. Next, 8 number, blue-green algae can able to fix atmospheric nitrogen into soil. So answer is true. Next, 9 number, yellow vein mosaic of Pindi is caused by bacteria. So answer is false. Yellow vein mosaic of Pindi is caused by virus, not by bacteria. Next is salts and edible oils are the common chemicals generally used to check the growth of microorganisms. So your answer is true. Here the answer for true false is given to you, and the false sentences, the corrected sentences is also given to you. So now let me see the next question, that is, give only one answer or one word answer for the question. First question, which microorganism causes common cold disease? So virus causes common cold disease. So the answer is virus. Next is, which protozoa causes malaria disease? So Plasmodium causes malaria disease. So Plasmodium is your answer. Next is, which disease is spread by female Anopheles mosquitoes? So malaria is spread by female Anopheles mosquito. So your answer is malaria. Next, 4 number, which microorganisms cause cholera disease? So bacteria cause cholera disease. So bacteria is your answer. Next question, which milk is considered as free from harmful microbes? So pasteurized milk is considered as free from harmful microbes. So your answer is pasteurized. Next, who discovered the Bacillus anthracis bacterium? So Robert Koch discovered the Bacillus anthracis bacterium. So Robert Koch is your answer. Next is, which unicellular microorganism is autotrophic? So Chlamydomonas is unicellular microorganism which is also autotrophic. So Chlamydomonas is your answer. Next is, which unicellular microorganism has irregular shape? So the answer is amoeba. Amoeba has irregular shape. Next is, what is the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol cold? So this process is known as fermentation. Next is, which microorganism cause rust of wheat? So fungi cause rust of wheat disease. Next is, which bacteria may get killed if antibiotics taken unnecessarily? So beneficial bacteria may get killed if antibiotics taken unnecessarily. Next, at about which temperature is milk heated for 15 to 30 seconds to make it free from harmful microbes? So it is heated up to temperature 70 degrees centigrade. Next is, which bacteria live in the root nodules of leguminous plant? So the name of the bacteria is rhizobium. The next question, who is the carrier of dengue virus? So female Aedes mosquito is the carrier for the dengue virus. The next is, what is used to preserve amla, raw mangoes and turmeric, etc.? So salt is used to preserve amla, raw mangoes and turmeric. So here the answer is given to you. The next question, answer the following question in one sentence. The first question is, give the name of any 5 viral disease. So viral disease are common cold, influenza, rabies, hepatitis and polio. The next question, give the name of any 5 bacterial disease. So bacterial disease are cholera, tuberculosis, typhoid, pneumonia and anthrax. Next question, give the name of disease caused by protozoan. So malaria and amoebic dysentery disease caused by protozoan. Next question, give the name of fungal disease. So the name of fungal disease are scabies, scasma, and ringworm, that etc. Next question, which fungi grow naturally on and around dunghill in monsoon? So in monsoon, mushroom or toadstool grow around and naturally on dunghill. Next is, which disease can be prevented by vaccination? So several diseases such as cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox, hepatitis, polio, etc. can be prevented by vaccination. Next is, in which natural sugar can yeast grow? So yeast can grow on natural sugars present in grains like barley, wheat and rice. The next question, what is the shape of amoeba and paramecium? So the shape of amoeba is irregular and the shape of paramecium is slipper-like. The next question, from which antibiotic production is achieved? So from certain bacteria and fungi, antibiotic production is achieved. Next question, state any four name of antibiotics. So the name of antibiotics are penicillin, streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin. The next question, how do pathogens enter our body? So pathogens enter our body through the air we breathe, the water we drink, or the food we eat. They also get transmitted by direct contact with an infected person or carried through an animal. The next question, how does food poisoning occur? So for food poisoning occurs due to the consumption of food spoiled by some microorganisms. Next is, how do we know that food is spoiled? So spoiled food emits or releases bad smells and has a bad taste and color change. From this we know that the food is spoiled. The next question, what are cold communicable disease? So the microbial disease that can spread from an infected person to a healthy person through air, water, food or physical contact are called communicable disease. Next question, give the example of unicellular microbes. So the example of unicellular microbes are bacteria, chlamydomonas, amoeba, paramecium, yeast, etc. The next question is, define the following. The first definition is microorganisms. So those organisms which we cannot see with naked eye are called microorganisms. The next is fermentation. So the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol by yeast is called fermentation. The next is pasteurization. So the milk is heated to about 70 degree centigrade temperature for 15 to 30 seconds and then suddenly chilled and stored. And this is called pasteurization. This process is known as the pasteurization. Now next question. That is, give 2 points of difference for the following. Please write the difference for the following. And that first one is between yeast and mold. So in the first column yeast, so yeast is a unicellular fungus, whereas mold is a multicellular fungus. Yeast can sustain its life with oxygen or in the absence of oxygen, whereas mold requires oxygen for living. The next difference is, it is beneficial fungus. Yeast is a beneficial fungus, whereas mold may beneficial or harmful fungus. Sometimes it is beneficial, whereas sometimes it is harmful. So this is the difference between yeast and mold. The next difference is between fungus and alga. So first difference is, there is no chlorophyll or other pigment in fungus cells. Whereas in alga, there is a chlorophyll or other pigment in their cells. In fungus, they are mostly white or black, whereas alga are green or of different colors. They are either parasite or saprophytic. In the fungus, fungus are either parasitic or saprophytic, whereas alga are autotrophic. So this is the difference between fungus and alga. Or you can write it is as for fungus and algae also. The next difference is between viruses and bacteria. So as viruses are very minor, that means small, they can be seen with an electron microscope only. Whereas bacteria can be seen with a compound microscope. Viruses do not have cellular structure, whereas bacteria possesses cellular structure. Viruses are definitely harmful to us, but bacteria are useful as well as harmful to us. Viruses are always or definitely harmful to us, but bacteria is sometimes useful as well as sometimes it's harmful also. So it is the difference between virus and bacteria. The next question is classification. So classify the following disease as viral disease, bacterial disease, fungal disease and protozoan disease. So let's we see, first is polio. So polio is the viral disease. Here we part divide it according to human, which occur in human and which is happen in the plants. So we classify by that also. So first is polio. So polio is the viral disease. Next is amoebic. So amoebic is protozoan disease. Next is dysentery. So dysentery is also protozoan disease. Next is cholera. It is a bacterial disease. Next is typhoid. It is also bacterial disease. And these all diseases are occur in the human. Next is hepatitis. So hepatitis is viral disease. Next is influenza. It is also viral disease. Next is malaria. So it is a protozoa disease. Here it is shown to you. Next is ringworm. So it is a fungal disease. Next is dengue. So it is a viral disease. Next now, the plant disease. So citrus canker. So it is a bacterial disease. The next is rust of wheat. It is a fungal disease. Next is yellow vein mosaic windy. So it is a viral disease, yellow vein of mosaic of windy. So here the classification is shown to you. Now next question, that is matching, match the following. So first one in column A, vaccine, antibiotic, virus and protozoa is given to you. In column B, streptomycin amoeba is produced antibody and dengue is given to you. First is vaccine. So it produces antibody. So your answer is D. Next is antibiotic. So name of one antibiotic, that is streptomycin. The next is virus. So virus causing disease is dengue. The next is protozoa. Kind of protozoa, that is amoeba. Here answer of the matching is also given to you. Now next is also another matching. In column A, leguminous plant, milk, preservative, rust of wheat is given to you. In column B, sodium benzoate, fungi, pasteurization and rhizobium is given to you. First is leguminous plant. So rhizobium stays in the leguminous plant's root. So your answer is rhizobium, option D. Next is milk. So to preserve milk, we are doing the pasteurization on the milk. So your answer is pasteurization. Next is preservative. A name for preservative. So sodium benzoate is a preservative. So your answer is sodium benzoate. The next is rust of wheat. So it is caused by fungi. So your answer is fungi B. The answer of this matching is also given to you here. So here our chapter gets over. In the next video, we will see next chapter. Thank you.